It's the Ron and Fez Show, and I'm your announcer, El Jefe. Now let's introduce your hosts. Two guys who think the Warner Brothers movie remake of the 80s TV show The Fall Guy should star Christopher Reeves. Here they are, Ron Bennington, Fez Watley, Radio's Kryptonite.
Is more cowbell. I could have used a little more cowbell. I gotta have more cowbell.
Tell you something.
No, wait. I'm the one who smells stink.
Buddies.
Oh, buddies, it's the Ron and Fez Show. I'm Ron, there's Fez.
Hiya, buddies.
Thursday night, Fezzy, and looking a little nasty outside.
Yeah, it was thunder booming earlier today.
You actually said thunder booming. Like some bad top 40 DJ.
Yes. Is that term out of, is that out of date, too?
Yes. It was out of date with Hump Day. They both left together.
Now, good thing we did have Thunder Boomers on Hump Day.
It's the Ron and Fez Show.
Today's Thursday.
Thanks to Don and Mike, Fezzy. Fabulous job. And I'm sure you guys all enjoyed listening to them. Now it's time to lower your expectations.
Just a bit.
It's the Ron and Fez Show. We'll be with you here till 11.
This is the four-hour version of our show. We do a one-hour version at 11 a.m. Right after Howard Stern.
Fezzy, trying to get used to the fact, and I don't understand how Jefe, he's the no-food guy now.
Yeah.
Things have been going on. You and I haven't always been able to catch dinner. We come in, and the other producer, Wardy, who we had.
Rory, not Wardy.
Whatever. He would always have food for us. El Jefe, what happened with the, it's time to start putting Ron and Fez on the outside of the restaurant, their nose pressed up against the window and just peeking in?
And two more cream puffs.
How do we change that?
You know, the whole reason I started working with you guys is I figured I food all the time, food
right.
All the time. I think we may have to make a call upstairs.
Call Wardy and find out where he was getting it from.
Rory. What? Rory.
Who?
Rory Hamptons.
And I saw J-Dubs leave here with a full pizza last night in a good mood. J-Dubs has been running the phones for us this week by Billy Staples, his MIA. He actually tells us last night, Fezzy, his dream has always been to be a radio station mascot.
Well, it's nice when you shoot for those stars.
Yeah.
When you aim high like that.
Other than the San Diego Chicken, has there ever been a famous radio mascot?
Wow, radio mascot? No.
What about the power pig? Remember the power pig would go around and wave to people?
Yeah, but I still don't think that was that really caught on.
A lot of stations used to have bees. A guy in a bee suit for some reason.
Maybe we could put J-Dubs in a bee suit.
Well, we're not exactly the bee. You know, one of the things you have to have bee somewhere in the callers. Maybe we have a J. We just dress him up as a big joint. And he's waving.
Or we add a few more Ks. WJFK-KK.
And he's just standing there with our call letters on and a big pointy hat.
I was just informed that this place used to be B106.
Yeah.
They had a big B.
Well, here's the thing.
Do we still have the suit?
No, we can't bring back the B. The last thing we want to do is bring back the B.
We'll be listening to WJFK.
Wait a minute. He says, what about the Hornet? The WJFK Hornet. Well, that might
be Yellow Jacket.
What would we have to do to change the B suit into a Hornet exactly?
I don't really know it all.
A longer tail or something?
What about, you know how they have those fat suits now? What if you just send you out as the WJFK chubby girl?
Ooh, that would be good.
Because a lot of guys are into that.
I'll do it.
Yeah, I think you could beat a lot of fans. What if you're like the WJFK infected prairie dog? Monkeypox seems big right now.
Yeah.
I can go around biting kids?
Biting, well, you're just actually teasing them.
Yeah.
You're not going to bite down hard, but... It's like, Mom, I got the WJFK monkeypox, and then everybody takes your picture with them.
Yeah, you could snarl and stuff, but you probably shouldn't bite.
All right, here's one for you, Fezzy. You know how everybody loves Santa Claus, right?
Right.
We dress him up as Santa Claus, and it's like one of those year-round Christmas town things.
Nice.
Those restaurants are always big.
106.7 WJFK, your Christmas station.
Let's do it.
Could you be Santa?
I could do anything.
He's up for it.
That's good. I'm glad you're open to ideas. Because we're going to find the perfect mascot for you.
Yeah, I would like to.
I still like the WJFK bottom. I think that'd be funny.
And you're just taking it?
Yeah, I'm just grinning bare.
From who?
Well, listeners. They come out.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if we needed a JFK topper.
No, the listener itself. We're trying to say to each listener with WJFK, you're on top.
Oh, okay. We'll bend over frontwards for you.
Come out and slap this producer.
What if you were like the WJFK baby who knows math? Well, you're like dressed like a baby, but you do like math equations for him, and you come off as a really smart baby.
Are you saying like an adult baby like they have on Jerry Springer?
No, we would try to pass him off as a real baby, but just one who uncannily knows math.
But a large baby, then.
Yeah, he's got to be large. There's nothing we could do about that unless we do one of those dwarf things where he's, got his knees and some giant baby booties.
Is this too obvious? We just dress him up as JFK and he's in the back waving to people as he's going down the road?
We take you around in a convertible?
Yeah, let's do it.
Ask not what your radio station can do for you.
Why is he going to talk like that? I thought that's the Simpsons mayor.
It's a J.F. Kennedy voice.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought that was the mayor.
It's the every Kennedy
Quimby
voice. They could do it for Jack, Bobby, or Teddy.
Sure.
Even Rose. My boys.
Is Rose still alive?
No, Rose died. She made it over 100, but she went a while back.
What else is big? You know, what if we dress him up as the WJFK cowboy and we just send him out to Redskins games? And blue and silver. Hey, it's me, the cowboy.
I'm sure you get a lot of attention.
What about the Rory Lion?
Rory.
Who?
Not that Rory. He's talking R-O-A-R-Y. You'd want to go out as a lion?
What else do they go out as?
A giant baby who knows math.
I like the lion, though. What's that, MGM? Like, we could tie him with MGM somehow.
Every time the show starts, he could just roar.
What about the WJFK Elvis?
That would be cool, an Elvis impersonator. Can you do an Elvis impression?
I can't do any impressions, really. I'm horrible.
Can you try? Could you try and say thank you very much?
Thank you very much.
That's good.
That's not bad. I mean, obviously, you're not going to spend a lot of time around the listeners. Just enough to say thank you very much, and you hand out a sticker or something.
Thank you very much for listening. This is great, my own.
You just pop pills every once in a while, and you're on your way.
What if you're like the WJFK guy with really, really fresh breath? That would be nice for the listeners. People just someone with refreshing breath.
People love fresh breath.
They can't get enough of it.
What about the WJFK kid toucher? Well, you're literally rubbing children.
Would I get sued for that, or would we? Would the station bail me out?
No, people are gonna love it.
Okay.
You'd be fine because people would be bringing you their kids.
Yeah.
Not like you're grabbing them.
And then you're giving out a free T-shirt. My kid got touched by the WJFK KT.
And all I got was a stupid T-shirt. What if you were like the big WJFK map of the area? when you came out, you're dressed as a big map of the Beltway. People could figure out, get directions from you, no matter where you're at. You could always put a little You Are Here sticker on you.
Well, I like it.
Well, I'd probably put it right on the unit area, so like all the people would be touching. Oh, I'm here's right here.
Here's the thing. You don't need to work dirty, okay? You're a young gentleman who's fresh into this business, and once you get hung up with that dirty thing, you'll work blue forever. I wouldn't work blue if I was you.
I think I'm pretty much stuck on it already.
Yeah.
But no, you would be a clean map. The star would be wherever it's at on your body.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes it will be the PUD. Yeah, that's going to happen.
So it's like Velcro, just stick it to wherever I'm at?
Yeah, there you go. Hey, Mike, you're on Ron Fez. What can we do for you? Hey, Mike.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, if you dress him up like JFK, I got an idea.
Yeah.
Just come around in a limo with half his head hanging out, and your motto can be Lose Your Mind with WJFK.
All right, Mike, I just don't want to remember the president, some people believe our greatest president, for the last moment of his life. I'd rather be across the board, you know? I'd rather we had him actually swimming to an island, pulling another guy behind him.
Oh, he could be PT-109 JFK.
Right.
We could put El Jefe in a Marilyn Monroe suit.
All right, this is not going to be El Jefe's. This is all J-Dubs right now. El Jefe tries to get into everything J-Dubs does. 866-277-4969. 866-277-4969. You heard it, folks. We're going to have a brand new mascot here, played by our own J-Dubs.
So if you want to call and give us a suggestion, because we're going to have to check out some costume rental places.
Mike, you're on Ron Fez.
Well, you know, WJFK is sort of a guy station, so how about the WJFK scrotum?
Big scrot.
Yeah.
A big scrot.
What do you think, J-Dubs?
How would the costume go?
It's just really an old hefty bag that we spray paint.
And put some hairs coming out of it.
Well, I don't know. I don't want to go that far. That's a little gross.
Got some air holes in it.
Yeah. Obviously, this has to be air holes.
What if you were like the WJFK human bird feeder? Where you were like just kind of covered with bird seed, and then you're out there promotions and stuff, and all the birds are just coming and just kind of pecking off of you, having some seed.
You don't see that as being like somewhat of a Hitchcock ripoff? I don't want people tuning in and think they're just going to hear Hitchcock stuff all the time.
We'll have to show. We'll put that one on the back burner.
Yeah, put it back there. Either that or you're, put it up the flagpole, see if anybody salutes. Toss it down the well, see if it splashes.
The WJFK flagpole. You're tall enough, kid.
How tall are you?
I'm 6'2".
Yeah, we might get stilts for you anyway.
Yeah.
We still think it's stilts. No matter what he does, I want him to be able to people see him far away.
One of those Uncle Sam's or Abraham Lincoln's on stilts that you see in the parades.
I never saw one of those. Where are these parades?
Yeah, they're great.
Mm.
You got to see them.
Yeah, I want to go. What about the WJFK coat rack? And wherever you go out to clubs, people can hang their coats on you. And the problem is, you're going to have to be there at closing time. But you're just standing there with a bunch of coats on.
You probably end up getting tips.
Yeah. Here's Mike. Mikey, you're on the air. Hey, Mike.
Hey, what about the WJFK jackass? You just dress him up like a donkey.
You know, that jackass thing was pretty big on MTV for a little while.
Maybe you can do something with that.
Maybe you guys can, like...
Just light yourself on fire or something.
Yeah, just do stupid stuff to me all the time.
That's kind of played for radio stations. That's the problem. Every radio station kind of picked that up. Randy, you're on Ron and Fez. Hey, Randy.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Good.
That the big baby thing is funny. How about the WJFKJ, and you can call him WJFKJ. He's a big smoking joint.
Yeah. What do you think of that, Fez? I mean... And if pod gets legal, we're right there.
Yeah, now we're on the forefront. Yeah. That's true. That's looking ahead.
Instead of the back front. Forefront.
You into the weed, J-Dubs?
No, I haven't touched it.
Bong hits? Years. What, are you more of a bong hit?
Yeah.
What do? Coke? What are you, crystal meth? You love the angel dust? Is that your thing? Ecstasy? What are you doing?
I'm not doing
all. Doing alls? Second alls?
Just drinking.
Roofies? The old lewds? What are you hanging with? What's your party stuff? What's your party flavor?
Just drinks.
Gin and juice?
Tequila.
You got your mind on your money and your money on your mind? Here's John. John, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, John.
Yeah, I got a recommendation for the mascot.
Yeah, he's right here.
Yeah, make him the Beltway Bubble Boy.
Beltway Bubble Boy, so like a boy in a plastic bubble.
Yeah, put him in the back of a pickup truck and ride him around the Beltway holding up a big sign.
I wouldn't mind that. When people think Bubble Boys, they'll be thinking of our station all the time.
WJFK.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Again, we're going to make sure air holes.
Yeah. Well, why? You have air has to keep the bubble together, right?
Put him in a big moonwalk. Then if he rolls out of the back of the truck, that would be cool.
Can't get hurt. I saw the movie Bubble Boy.
He was fine. He got hit by a bus, and he was good.
And I'm wondering when there's going to be a Bubble Boy 2. I mean, that first one was just so great.
They're always really slow on the good sequels.
Yeah. It just ended so suddenly. I just wanted more. As I'm there, I go, I can't believe I'm so disappointed that this is over.
What if you were the WJFK hurt deer, and you're like in a deer suit, but you're kind of limping around, like one paw, one hoof got hurt.
And then people don't know whether they have to shoot him or not, right?
Yeah.
Should we put him down or will you better? That's the whole big question.
It would be a really sympathetic mascot.
I would love that.
You know, the kids would, you know, they love deer, you know, and all the grown-ups would be like, oh, the deer's hurt.
Here's the only problem. Suppose there is a hurt deer somewhere. People go up to it. They're trying to get tickets. And they're thinking J-Dub's an a-hole.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
True.
That's my problem, Fez. But I'm thinking big picture. I think outside the box. Adam, you're on Fez.
Hey, Adam.
Hey, buddies.
Adam.
Hey, make him crash a Cessna and call him the WJFK Jr.
You know, all the girls used to like him, too.
Who's that?
JFK Jr.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
John. You know what we do, maybe, is just put him in that short suit. You know, remember that suit? And he's always saluting people. And, oh, that gets so many tears when that happened.
People would love to see that if we could replicate that little suit.
Why couldn't we? What could be easier than that? It's Tim. Tim, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Tim.
Hey.
What's better than being in the forefront? You could have him be the WJFK foreskin and promote circumcision.
Foreskin.
Okay.
And that
you're
way...
You Redskins.
Yeah, that way he's...
Yeah, and you're helping the community out.
The skins at all times. And you're helping out the community, and you're pushing circumcision, which, you know, most of us here are circumcised.
And a team booster?
Yeah.
Boy, that combines a lot of nice elements.
Maybe you can get your own halftime show.
That's an all-around thing, man.
Oh, yeah, it's an all-around thing. 866-277-4969. Yeah, it's exciting times here. At the radio station, Fez.
Whatever you were the WJFK boy wizard, that Harry Potter's really popular. That fifth book's coming out. That's going to be huge.
You know what I say to that, Fez?
What?
Played.
Played?
Played.
Even with the new book coming out?
Played. This new book is going to sell like 30 copies. Why read the book when the movie's coming out before you know it?
That movie's going to take a while to come out.
Played. Here's Aaron. Aaron, you're on the air. Hey, Aaron.
Hey, how about the FK nipple, so when people...
And that's all. Oh.
So people what?
Oh, you got
I think he just wanted to say nipple.
Yeah, well, it worked for him. I thought it, you know, worked out okay. Here's Mike. Mike, you're on Ron Fez. Max, I'm sorry. Max.
Hey, guys. I got it. The WJFK Ballard, and he can dress up like K Ballard.
The in-law.
Exactly right. You know, meanwhile, Junior on the phone there had no idea who K Ballard.
Of course. Why would he? But here's
the thing. It was before 1984.
It
wasn't Alex P. Keaton's mom. He's not going
to
know.
Now, we do have to worry about the younger demos. And I'm not sure that K Ballard has the same kind of heat for the people who weren't there for Merv Griffin.
Yeah, I guess that's true. He's not going to know Karen Valentine either, then. Don't these punks watch Match Game for
Yeah, you know, Nick at Night, all those things, the Game Show Network, watch it all.
I'm sure we could get a Kay Ballard suit, and if we don't, we could make one easy enough. All you need is a mop.
And a trumpet. Remember when she would always pull out a trumpet?
And a lot of heavy eyeshadow. And we're all set with WJFK Ballard.
Here's Wayne. Wayne, you're on Run the Fez.
Yeah, I'll call him the WJFK fag and dress him up like a cigarette.
Well, the problem is that's Fez's gig.
What?
Nothing. I was just
I'm not going to be the mascot. Not in the summertime. I ain't putting on a suit.
866-277-4969. This is exciting times, Fezzy.
It really is. I love a brainstorming session.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to help out the station here, plus the community.
Matt, you're on the air. Hey, Matt.
I think a perfect idea would help everybody would be the WJFK bum. You walk up to him, give him a couple change in his coffee cup, and he gives you a bumper sticker. He makes a little change on the side, and every time you see a bum in D.C., you turn it to JFK.
I remember we don't use the word bum anymore.
Homeless?
Yeah, homeless.
WJFK homeless guy. Which, again, would just be Kate Ballard.
And they aren't bums. Quite a few of them are mentally ill.
Would that work for you, J.W.?
That would work for me, but the thing I like was the WJFK nipple, because I have some insanely big nipples. So I'm going to show them to you.
No, I get really
I'm going to show them to you.
I don't even like mad nips as it is.
Look at these things.
Oh,
these are insanely big nipples.
They are huge.
Are you lactating? What are you doing?
Why are your nips so big?
I don't know. They've been like this since I was like 12.
Do you only have two?
Yes.
They're the size of saucers. It's like a pie plate. Two pie plates on his chest. How did that happen?
I don't know.
Were you heavier before and then you lost weight?
Actually, I was up to like 270 pounds for a while. So.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you stretched out your nips. That's your problem.
Now you need implants. How did you fit the nips?
Reduction.
What did you get the... To lose all the weight.
Was there a litter of pigs suckling off of you at any point?
No, to lose the weight,
that would be so cute to have them doing that.
I actually started smoking and I lost all the weight.
You didn't diet at all? How old were you when you weighed 270?
It was only...
12?
4 years ago.
Well, I don't know how old that was.
You know, you've got something wrong with you, young man. You're too thin, although you're wearing the same clothes as you did 4 years ago. So it's a smart idea. All right, we got to take a break.
Casey, put the weight back on.
We're back with the new WJFK nipple. Man, nips are just totally gross to me anyway. And you actually need a nip reduction. We got to take a break, Fezzy. When we come back, we're going to name them 866-277-4969. Run a Fez.